everyone! In this video, we are going to introduce you to Evive, an extraordinary device that makes DIYing easy, smart and fun. How to install its battery, how to charge it, and discuss the various power input and output modules. Let's begin by discussing what Evive is. Evive is a palm-sized all-in-one electronics prototyping device that makes STEM learning for kids easy and project making for hobbyists fun. Evive's core is made of Arduino Mega 2650, thus providing us with all the features of Arduino, along with a number of extra features like the easy plug-and-play interface, reprogrammable menu-based visual interface, precise voltage and current sensing with data visualization and logging features, inbuilt mini oscilloscope, function generator, and many others. To see how it works, let's first install its battery. Unfasten the screws at the back using the screwdriver provided in the kit and remove the bottom half of the casing gently. Now take the battery provided in the kit and plug the battery connector into the empty male socket given here. Secure the battery in the slot provided using the double-sided tape. Take care that the battery wire remains within the case. Now, place the bottom half back and fasten all four screws. The battery is in its place now. Time to power Evive up. The power switch is located on the top corner of the right surface. It is a three-way switch with the middle state corresponding to off. Sliding the switch to the downward corresponds to internal state, which means Evive will be powered by the internal 3.7 volt battery. Sliding the switch upwards corresponds to external state, which means external power supply is required to power Evive up through the power inputs given here. For now, let's select the internal state by sliding the power switch downwards. As it turns on, a menu will appear on the TFT screen and the power LED will turn on. Now let's see how to charge Evive. To check whether it is charged or not, check the battery status. It is displayed on the top right corner of the screen. When the battery is low, you can power Evive externally in three ways: via a USB cable, DC adapter, or external battery. Let's have a look at all the three one by one. First, let's use the USB cable. Connect Evive to your computer via the cable and slide the power switch upward. The status LED for charging will turn on. Once the battery is fully charged, it will turn off. Now, let's charge it using a DC adapter of 12 volt 2 amperes rating here. If you want to just charge Evive, the power switch should be in the off state. If you want to work and charge at the same time, slide the power switch to external. Finally, let's see how to charge Evive using an external battery. While connecting the external battery, pay extra attention to its polarity. In our case, the red wire is the positive terminal. Therefore, we will connect it like this. If you want to just charge Evive, the power switch should be in the off state. If you want to work and charge at the same time, slide the power switch to external. You do not have to worry too much about the battery being overcharged and other damages while powering up Evive externally, as it comes with reverse polarity and overvoltage protection that keeps Evive safe and sound. Now that we have had a look at the power input modules and how to charge Evive using them, let's have a look at the output modules. Just like you can power Evive in multiple ways, you can also take output in several ways. Four to be precise. First is VSS. Here you will get an output power that is exactly the same as it is supplied to the Evive externally. Second is VVR. You can vary the external input power using the variable voltage knob. You can monitor this variable voltage on the Evive screen and take it as output at VVR. Next is the fixed 5 volt supply. And the last one is 3V3, where you will get a fixed 3.3 volt supply, which is required in case of advanced sensors. Well, that's all for this video. In the next video, we'll explore the plug and play interface by performing some simple and interesting activities. If you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. For more such engaging videos, subscribe to STEMpedia and follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Bye-bye!